come on, hurry up, bring it in, you know,
I'm only an inch tall, come on!
Work harder!
There you go!
Thank you.
You're welcome!
I said thank you, now bug off! Or whatever you tiny ponies do.
Go on,
shoot, shoot! Go on!
Run, remove!
A magic mirror. Neat. Okay, let's get this out of the way. Mirror, mirror on the wall. Is this not the fairest kingdom of them all?
Technically, you're not a queen.
Ahem.
But you can become one. All you have to do is marry a prince.
Go on.
So, sit back and relax, my dear Cid, because it's time for you to meet your next bachelors. And here they are. Bachelor number one.
Hello.
Bachelor number one is also a very talkative bachelor.
Indeed.
Well, where his colorful personality is.
Yes, quite right.
The actual persona he has lacks. For he is only white and gray with a little bit of black. His damn wardrobe doesn't have any color to it. Where does he get his styles from?
Well, I say.
But anyways, he is very repetitive in his name, so here he is, Bachelor number one, DJ, DJ! Bachelor number two. He claims to be the head of his clan, but quite frankly, I don't think he can lead a pack of kindergartners.
He is
the chief of the Scarneck tribe, which I've never really met, nor do I really want to meet. Here he is, Chief Scarneck!
Oh, do you think my clan's really that stupid?
Yes, they are. And then here we have Bachelor number three.
If I could just have your attention for 1 second, Mr. Man in the Mirror, but I believe I can introduce myself.
Very well, because everyone else seems
Hello,
to be...
Hello, my lady. Look at the Ever Bachelors. Now back to me. Now back to the Ever Bachelors. Now back to me. Sadly, they aren't me. Look again. Yeah, it's a plate full of white chocolate macadamia cookies. Look again. The cookies have become diamonds. Anything's possible when you're... Lovely Prince is the man of your dreams. I actually am a horse.
And his name is Joker. So, who is your decision? Bachelor number one, bachelor number two, or bachelor number three?
Look, bachelor, now bachelor, number one.
Number three!
Damn!
Miss Her Butler Gothic, you have chosen Joker.
Oh, he's perfect! Great, now I have to find
Double sun power!
Just a little thing. Just one little thing that I forgot.
Whatever.
Yes, yeah, but yeah. After sunset.
Quiet! Now I'd find someone to go on a freaking quest for me. Who am I going to get at such short notice?
Why hasn't the stupid truck given this room yet?
What? Let him be late to the portal!
Huh? Look, if I give you guys back your land, will you go fetch something for me?
Sure, but...
You destroyed our land?!
What the hell?!
Look, I didn't destroy your land, okay?
Screw this shit! Transition to the actual reading! She can get her own f***ing prince!
I didn't vote for her!
Wait, who are you?
I'm a tiny pony!
Vanilla, we got a snow around the truck!
That's an awful collector!
No!
I'm not even reasoning with you guys when I could just stop you.
No!
Fine, we're going to the f***ing prince! Guys, get the mini-jet!
Stick with us, cause Jogger and the Dinobots are gonna do it all.
Alright, what's up, guys? Lama 5 here, also known as Joker, and welcome to My Little Pony Friendship is Magic Blind Greetings for the Thunderbolts!
The Thunderbolts!
Yes, indeed.
We already, already went through this. We are not the Thunderbolts.
Okay, but who's with us this week? Who's with us this week? Same people from yesterday, actually. So, please welcome. He's about the size of a doornail. Don't ask what that is. You'll find out later. Vanilla Beam!
I knew I should have gotten the turbo.
He's actually not a chief of anything, but he does have a scar on his neck covered by human skin. Chief Skarnik!
Yeah, you're just jealous.
He's got two names, and actually, his second name is two names. DJ DJ Aerodynamic!
I am a very large micropony.
And also, the most talented female impressionist in the entire world, please welcome her butler Gothic, but we call her Sydney!
Well, I'm not that talented.
Her Emmy-Con is blushing.
So, if you haven't seen the show before, what happens is we take a random script from My Little Pony Friendship is Magic Season 4, and with our varied voices and impressions, we pick on various roles given to us by a chopper. Speaking of, who's choosing for who today? Ooh, gosh, dude. You know, actually, I'm going to do it this way. What? So, I'm going to decide for... Arrow's going to decide for Vanilla. Vanilla will decide for Chief. Chief will decide for Sydney. And Sydney will decide for me. So, I guess I get to choose the roles. Until then...
Impressions.
All right, we're back. So, for Rainbow Dash, I'll be doing Dr. Phil for Bulk Biceps. Arrow will be doing one of the knights who say, me. For Scootaloo, we got Vanilla doing Fat Albert. For Spike, Chief will be doing Squidward. For Applebloom, Sydney will be doing Charlotte LeBeau from The Princess and the Frog. For Twilight Sparkle, I'll be doing Baby Herman from Who Framed Roger Rabbit. For Crystal Gara, Aerodynamic doing Professor Frink from The Simpsons. For Princess Cadence, Vanilla will be doing Yosemite Sam. I don't know why I put an E at the end there, Yosemite Sam. For Shining Armor, we got Chief doing Ernie from Sesame Street. For Miss Harshmoney, Sydney will be doing Marek Ishtar from Yu-Gi-Oh! The Bridge Series. For Sweetie Belle, we got Aerodynamic doing Edwin Van Cleef. I'm guessing that's from Mortal Warcraft.
Yes.
Whoa, and for Little Shine, he was doing Adam Wee. So, without further ado, let's get to it! Hello, welcome back to Dr. Phil Show, and things just got real. Now listen up, folks, we're almost there, so got a few things to say first. Who here besides me thinks that this show is the best show on national television?
Me!
And no matter what your sport is, we're gonna give it our best. Because we've all got a genuine shot at suing their own family. With the possible exception of Bulk Biceps, or those night guys over there, Flourishy and me. I mean, we're good and all, but we're up against Oprah in the aerial relay, so I think we got a chance to win. After all, Oprah's pretty fat, can't run for shit. I mean, let's not kid ourselves here. I mean, she is fat. So I can surprise she ain't even been on Dr. Phil's show yet, you know?
Hey, I know I'm fat. We have absolutely no shot at getting gold either.
Well, that's because you're carrying the flag for Ponyville, fat ass. In the opening ceremony, there are no winners.
Hey, winners or not, we both gotta go away.
That's the spirit we should have here on the Dr. Phil Show. You hear that, everyone? Winners or not, we all still have the chance to sue our own family. Na 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 na. Well, let's still try to win and have lots of stuff, too, okay? My little bunny, my little bunny, my little bunny, Mr. B, my little bunny, 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 my little bunny.
It's all in there, gang. Leave it to Squidward. Champion gear carrier for all your gear carrying needs.
And the Ponyville flag? You sure? What about the flagpole?
And with the portable ramp. Wow!
Give it a rest, Applebloom.
Oh, she's just nervous, that's all. Ha ha. Perfectly understandable. Whenever I'm afraid, I'll forget something or start to panic. I have a simple trick. I count to 10, and by the time I'm done, I've calmed myself enough to get the job done right every time. Easy peasy, cider squeezy. Ha ha. Alright. Put me down, you Neanderthal.
Hey, hey, what's going on?
Spike, are you alright?
A thousand pardons, oh great and honorable Spike, the brave and glorious. Hi.
Who the what now?
Thank you for bringing that lily liver varmint to us. Okay, Spike. We'll have our lily liver hoof ponies to go grab your bags.
They can hang back a second and tell me what's going on first. So, the ponies here think I'm some kind of hero, huh? More of the green ones, please. I like the green ones.
You know, the last time you was here, you got the crystal heart to Princess Cadence in time to save this entire empire from destruction. You didn't have time to change your diapers, though.
You're known here throughout the empire as the greatest gunslinger in the north, south, east, and west!
And isn't that awesome? You're a big shot here, Spike. You see that? No, not that. That! Yeah, that. That's you.
Huh. Hello, gorgeous.
This is why we all hope you do us an honor of lighting the torch in the opening ceremony. You'd be the very first dragon in the history of the Equestria Games to do so.
Oh, of course I'll do it. And, bonus, I can do it with my fire breath.
Places for the procession, everybody. 2 minutes.
And you're quite certain you also understand exactly what you're supposed to do?
I stand where you tell me until you give the signal, and then I walk over and light the torch.
Couldn't be similar. Mr. Purple Dragon Guy, are you coming? Honestly. Would some pony help him walk?
Now, please welcome the delegation from Ponyville.
Ponyville forever!
Yeah!
Well, I suppose that's satisfactory.
Yeah.
This is a signal! I'm giving you the signal now, Mr. the Dragon!
Come on, Squidward. Calm yourself. Count to 10. 1, 2, 3, 1,000, 14,000, 20,000, 30,000!
What be the unforgotten problem?
Tell me this isn't happening.
Roger, we got a problem.
Mr. the Dragon, would you like a torch already?
I don't know what it is, but I just don't have the stuff today. Did you bring a match?
Oh, for frig's sake, you're a friggin' fire-breathing dragon!
Then, some cough drops, maybe?
Oh, for frig's sake!
Never mind, I'll keep trying.
Will one of you varmints go down there and help him?
Light. Light!
Phew. Nice job, Toots.
Oh, how did you do that?
I'm not sure.
Oh, well, better late than never.
Let the games begin!
Woohoo!
Woo!
Yeah!
Yahoo!
Alright, that's the end of Act 1, and it's time for the games to begin. You know what that means? It means in Act 2, I'm choosing for Sydney. Sydney's choosing for Cheep. Cheep's choosing for Vanilla. Vanilla's choosing for Arrow. And Arrow's choosing for me. So, we'll be right back with you with the real Equestria Games. Until then...
Impressions.
Alright, we're back. So, for Spike, I'll be doing Bender from Futurama. For Rarity, we got Cindy doing Vinyl Scratch. For Applejack, Sheep, we'll be doing Yugi Moto from the Yugi Elite series. For Rainbow Dash, we got Vanilla doing The Foo from Beauty and the Beast. For Twilight Sparkle, we got Arrow doing Scrappy from Futurama. For Shining Armor, I'll be doing Kent Brockman from The Simpsons. For Pinkie Pie, we got Cindy doing Lois Griffin. You don't know who that is. Wow. For Security Guy, we got Chief doing Stitch from Lilo and Stitch. For Miss Hushman, we got Vanilla doing the Mario from the CDI games. For Bright Smile, we got Arrow doing Richard Nixon. For Elbow Grease, Cindy, we're doing Kevin from Ed, Edd, and Eddy. For Nailist Border, Chief will be doing Waluigi, and for the Crystal Pony in the crowd, Jim and Manila will be doing Apu from The Simpsons. So, without further ado, let's get to it!
Aww, there are little superstars! You were fabulous!
Made me sit up proud like a cornstalk in August.
Wow, you didn't miss a shot, Squirt! You're the greatest flag twirler in the whole world!
You three were really wonderful. And didn't Pony know what was going on with Spike?
He sure needed to be having a tough time of it out there.
Huh? Oh yeah, he put things right in time, though.
It was me, Scruffy, the janitor. I didn't want him to be embarrassed, so cast a secret spell to light it for him. Mm-hmm.
Oh, snap! Have you told him?
Nope.
You gotta tell him, just in case, Joey.
Mm-hmm. I'm afraid how he'll take it. I don't know what pride he takes in a job well done. Just like Scruffy.
Here he comes now. At casual. Hi, Gaston. Wait, Gaston's not here. Sup?
Everything okay?
Yeah, I guess. But I don't know, meatbag. Stupidest thing happened down there.
About that.
I was trying to light the torch of all of Equestria watching my shiny metal ass and feeling like the hugest failure ever. And then the thing just lit. I must be more cooler than I thought.
Here I was afraid you'd be upset.
Why would I be upset to discover that I can light fire with my mind?
What?
Only Gaston can do that!
It's the great and honorable Bender, the brave and glorious!
Dude, can we get your autograph?
Nah, you can buy my shiny metal ass!
Doesn't look that shiny.
Shinier than yours, meatbag.
How you saved our country last time you were here was truly amazing!
Heh, you wanna know somebody else is amazing? Check this out. Yeah, don't worry. Once a person deflames through brain power, I'll sign another one for you.
Spike, a word.
Hey, you better be careful with that. Might burst into flames later. Hopefully. Delayed reaction. Hey, Scruffy, what the hell is it? Hold on. Give me a sec. If I can set fire to stuff in my mind, my reading must be just around the corner! Yeah! And I predict that you are about to ask me to set fire to something but my metal ass.
Nope. You can't.
The hell do you just say? Okay, fine. Ooh! If I can set stuff on fire, then how do you explain what happened down there in front of thousands and thousands of...
I did it. Scruffy. Scruffy did it. Scruffy cast a spell for you.
How the hell do you do magic, Scruffy? Ah, the silent treatment, eh? Right in front of thousands and thousands. Don't know why I'm saying that, just feel like it.
Scruffy, sorry, Spike. Just couldn't stand to see you stuck like that. Understand, don't you?
No, I'm gonna kill you in your sleep later. Later, meatbag!
Spike?
Wow. All great and honorable Scruffy the brave and glorious. Can I get your autograph?
Beat it, mustache. Why don't you go ask somebody special instead? Ooh.
And it is a beautiful day here at the Equestria Games. And our next event, the Aerial Relay.
That's Joey and Tristan.
Oh, no, we can't be late for that.
Miss, stop right over there.
Unicorns will no longer be admitted without a disabling spell to prevent cheating. And make sure you don't even try to cast a spell, or we'll know it.
Oh, what? It's because I'm a DJ?
If Ponyville medals here, well, I've 8 medals so far, putting us tied for the lead with Cloudzale, unless Cloudzale medals here too.
Miss Hoshmini, I know you're really busy, but...
Uh-huh. What is it, little dragon?
You know, maybe there's something else I can do for the games. You know, something really worthy of the Crystal Empire's admiration, maybe a load of money involved.
What are you talking about, little Iron Man? You lit all those toasts on fire.
Yeah, well, actually, that wasn't real. Last year, it was me. But it wasn't like breathing, it was like my ass doing it, so I don't feel like proud about it.
That wasn't worthy enough for you? Ugh, for pony's sake. Next thing you know, he'll be asking to rescue the princess. Celebrities.
Wait, that's it!
We got Silverfang in attack mode.
And congratulations to all our medalists from Springfield. Everyone else can suck it. And now the anthem.
And I shall do the honor of singing the anthem, meatbags.
Woo! Yeah!
Heh heh. Bender, what the hell do you think you're doing?
Well, you know how they always play that stupid music at every single sporting event? Well, I know all the words to our anthem. Well, actually, no, I don't. I actually have something really cool planned instead. But just sell us an anthem for now, stupid meatbags. And I will now sing them for you now. Loud and proud to the enjoyment of all. And if you don't like it, you can bite my shiny metal ass.
And now, the Springfield anthem as sung by Bender. Like hell, I'm singing the Springfield anthem. They only play the anthem for the winner, Spike. And the Wonderbolts are from Springfield. We just bought them this morning.
Well, for one, I don't know the words of the stupid Cloudsdale anthem. Who the frick knows what the Cloudsdale anthem is?
Sing for us, O great and honorable Spike, the brave and glorious.
Oh, that's right, I don't have a freaking esophagus.
Oh, well... I got it. 1 second. Oh, it's a stupid Springfield anthem. Yeah, it's something like this for us. Yeah. We are the champions, meatbags. Yeah, we'll keep on fighting until the end. We are the champions. We are the champions. No time for me back, cause I got a metal ass. And you can bite it.
Nail it!
Alright, that's the end of Act 2! So, for Act 3, it's time we all go in pairs. And this is really difficult because actually only two can go in pairs. Vanilla, you and me and you, why don't we see who is better? That's not, let's just get into a pair. And should Chief choose for Sydney or for Sydney choose for Chief? Ooh. Who choose for who last act?
I chose for Chief.
Alright, so Chief's gonna choose for Sydney choose for Arrow, and Arrow choose for Chief. So, take a second, choose the roles. Until then, impressions. Alright, we're back. So, for Spike, we got Sydney doing number 5 for Code in the Kids Next Door. For Sweetie Belle, we got Arrow doing Zoidberg. For Apple Bloom, we got Chief doing Bill Cosby. For Scootaloo, I'll be doing Joe Swanson. For Shining Armor, Vanilla will be doing Herbert the Pervert. For Applejack, we got Sydney doing Hermione Granger. For Pinkie Pie, Arrow will be doing Mickey Mouse. For Rainbow Dash, we got Chief doing Patrick Starr. For Princess Cadence, I'll be doing Randy Newman from... Family Guy, pretty much. For Twilight Sparkle, I've been doing Denzel Crocker from Fairly Odd Parents. And finally, for the second security guard, I've been doing Doc Brown. So, without further ado, let's get to it!
Best Buy,
gum and the girls and I are going out and get some jello.
Nah, number 5 gotta pack this stuff up.
But you've been moping in there for almost the entire games.
And tonight's the closing ceremonies it is.
Which means we leave tomorrow, ergo the packing.
And so the games conclude as they always do, with the Ice Archer at finals. Ice Archers, take your place.
Too bad Ponyville doesn't have any Ice Archers competing. We don't have anyone to root for.
Ha ha! That's okay. Ponyville has 37 medals, and Cloudsdale 36. So looks like we'll be medal champs of the games anyway. Woohoo!
But Cloudsdale has 2 Ice Archery finalists down there now. If they both place, Cloudsdale wins the medal count.
So you're saying that it all comes down to this one event?
Pretty much.
Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy, oh boy, oh boy! Twilight, come take this extra seat next to me and freak out over the medal count. I'll show you how. Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy!
Actually, I was looking for fairies!
Well, you see, you wouldn't come be, no, have the nothing with the jello with us and the girls.
Please, you have to believe me. We tried to talk him into it. Don't hurt me.
But he wouldn't listen, Peter.
You can have his extra seat, though. Twilight?
Spike! Are you in here? If you're not, you fail!
yeah. Number 5, super busy. Look at all this packing left to do. Crazy, right?
No more hiding out! You're coming with me! Now!
Okay, fine. I'll come. Can number 5 at least wear these?
That'll accept.
Those aren't your average arrows. They freeze whatever part of the target they hit. Whoever encases their entire target in ice first wins. Keep your eye on number 7 from Cloudsdale. He's my favorite.
Patrick, you have no idea what you just said.
Yeah, I don't. Neither do I.
Honestly, Spike, I don't know why you're being so hard on yourself. I only gave you a D!
Number 5 let everyone down. Twice. You never let any pony down, so you don't have any idea what it's like.
Of course I don't. I'm a teacher. I only give out Fs! But that's not the point. The torch got lit. The aerial relay teams got their medals. No harm, no foul. Except you got an F!
Can we at least watch from inside here? Number 5, not sure if she's ready to face the crowds in the stand just yet.
Oh no!
We should take the giant ice shard and push it somewhere else!
Somebody cut that disabling spell! Cutting the spell.
There's no time, Mother!
Number 1, number 3, move!
That was awesome!
Most amazing!
Oh boy!
I give it a C.
I just wanted to thank you personally for saving those ponies and the games of great line of respect the Raven Glorious. You must be very proud.
Number 5 guesses.
You guess?
You shouldn't be guessing. You should already know.
Number 5 just saw what needed to be done and reacted. Just so happens number 5 can breathe fire, and if any of you could do that, you'd have done the same. Forgive me for being blunt, Spike, but you're not making a lick of sense. Well, that's just how number 5 feels.
Wait a second. I get it. Maybe I should use a net instead of my anti-fairy. Oh, sorry. Sorry, wrong discussion. You keep saying you let every pony down, but we all keep saying you didn't. You know who's disappointed in you, Spike? Me! And only you can make it right by studying for your tests! What would that take, Spike?
Meh, number 5 don't know. Can you turn back time? Because number 5 would like a do-over on that opening ceremony.
We can't turn back time, but would you do me the great honor of lighting fireworks in my place at this closing ceremonies tonight? Something like that.
Come on, Spike! You saved the Crystal Empire twice! I think you can light some fireworks! Or should I give you your final grade?
Number 5. Guess she can at least give it a shot.
Stupendous! You get a B.
Hooray!
Hooray!
Oh boy! Ha ha! We did it! Ponyville won the medal count, and only by 1 medal! Ha
ha! Hmm.
Wonder which medal that was. Bam!
How does it feel to have opened the best Equestria Games in Ponyville history, Squirt?
Probably as good as it feels going down the slope with some gel or going zip-zop-zoobity-bop. Or closing band.
No one's Miss Harshwinnie.
Hi, I'm Joker. I'd like to apologize for this moment, but apparently Miss Harshwinnie has just had a heart attack and can't make it on stage right now. Please, a moment of silence for Miss Harshwinnie.
Moment's over!
You know, it's kind of weird. No matter how many times others tell you you're great, all the praise in the world means nothing if you don't feel it inside. Sometimes to feel good about yourself, you gotta let go of the past. That way, when the time comes to let your greatness fly, you'll be able to light up the whole sky.
Ah, the end of the meeting! Yay!
Yay.
So,
while I go ahead and just note down Act 1, Act 2, and Act 3, what did y'all think of the reading?
It was fun, again.
Was good. It was a good all-rounder. Special. Had a good time.
I think special, yeah. But it was definitely...
But yes... Barry cut this out after I do the thing, but we're going to take a second to choose the impressionist of the week and cut our votes in. So, be right back with you after this transition! Alright, we're back and we're ready to launch in 3, 2, 1, let it rip! Whoa, Nazzle. Oh, Arrow was first. Nice, Arrow. Fast.
What?
Arrow
was...
What? Lily Liver Varmint was quick to the draw!
Alright, Arrow, who are you voting? Act, who are your votes for then, Arrow?
Hang on!
Well, for Act 1, my vote goes to, I believe it was Vanilla for his Yosemite Sam.
Vanilla
gets
the best Yosemite Sam.
Yeah, you know, Yosemite Sam is always enjoyable. For Act 2, I really liked your bender. You really nailed it. man, like, especially with that anthem singing, that was really good. And then Act 3, of course, goes to Vanilla again for Crocker, because Denzel Crocker is always hilarious when he's failing his students.
You get an A!
And then overall, though, I had to go with your bender.
Woohoo!
You have to be my worst student ever!
Yeah.
You get an F! Minus! 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 Minus!
Yeah, bite my shiny middle ass, Crocker!
Alright, Vanilla's next. God damn it, was I last every time?
No.
Was actually, usually I'm first.
I'm first on my screen. Anyways. Number 1, Act 1 was hard to decide because...
You want
to
give some runners-up for Act 1 then?
Runners-up for Act 1, definitely the Knights Who Say Knee, Charlotte LaBeouf, your Dr. Phil, of course. Mm. And that's pretty much it. But number 1, I had to give to Baby Herman.
Of course.
Huh?
Yeah, his baby Herman... was definitely nailed to a T. Number 2, I had to give it to Bender because the improv was just great.
Thank you.
The improv
thing was real.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
And then number 3, even though I liked number 5 and Randy Newman, I had to give it to Chiefs Bill Cosby for, again, the improv, yeah, basically.
The improv was good, Chief. You just need to work on the voice.
Yeah, you just gotta work on the impression, but you've got the improv down to a T. But my overall vote has to go to Bender for the nail in the coffin was definitely his performance, his drunken performance.
Yahoo!
Okay, who's next? Is it? It's not me. What the heck happened here? Oh no, I'm at the top. Right. Oh, I'm so sorry, guys. I'm so sorry. Mine blended in with the rest of the thing. So, for me, Act 1, Yosemite Sam, absolutely freaking fantastic. Just crack up every time I just hear, oh! Act 2, CDI Mario, because, fuck. You burn all those toasters.
What the hell even is a CDI Mario? What?
I just love the way, it's just the way you said it. What is a CDI Mario?
Well, it's a very rare specimen.
And Act 3, Denzel Crocker. I'm sorry, Vanilla just really hit it out of the park today with his impressions. I am so sorry. Alright.
Well, guess... Get an A!
So, gee, I wonder who my vote goes to. So, yeah, overall, I'd say I enjoyed your CDI Mario most of all just because... Just because that one line...
How many toasters?
Alright, so who's next? It's Sydney. So, Sydney, who do your things go for?
Well, in Act 1, I liked Yosemite Sam's. Vanilla's Yosemite Sam.
Well, thank you, little lady.
Act 2, I like the drunken singing of Bender. So I gave it to Joker. And Act 3, just Herbert the Pervert. even though he didn't have that many lines, I had to give it to Herbert the Pervert in Act 3. So overall, I give it to Vanilla for Herbert.
Come over to my house anytime.
I just need some master list for how I can do Herbert the Pervert perfectly.
Alright, so, 2 votes for Vanilla, 2 votes for me. Chief Skarnik, you're the scapegoat. Time to find out who won. Chief Skarnik, tell us your votes!
Act 1. Ah! Way to give it away already.
Well, they're going to find out in like 5 seconds.
Act 1, I gave it to Joker for his Dr. Phil. Because, suing our own families.
Yes.
Yeah. Very, very nice how you put Dr. Phil in there. Very nice on the improv. Act 2 I gave to Vanilla for his LeFou. Although I was a huge fan of Bender and CDI Mario.
You can bite my shiny metal ass with that one, meatbag.
In Act 3 I had to give it to Vanilla's Crocker again. I love his Crocker and... He just does it so well.
Chief, we're gonna get so many hate comments for that.
What?
So, it's like, just wait! I'm eventually gonna get an ear on my neck!
They were like, oh my god, LeFou and Denzel Crocker again. Can't you guys choose anything else from Vanilla's list?
But they're so dang good!
I know as well, but I'd still try to choose other ones from his list that he hasn't done before.
Hey, people in the comments section, why don't you decide for me then?
They would, but we don't live stream. Guess we're not known to live stream too. Look forward to that in season 5. So, by one snatcher of a point, and for the LeFou over a Bender, Vanilla wins the Impressionist of the Week!
Not and even all a smidgen of a bounce!
Smidgen of a bounce?
Smidgen
of a bounce. Ooh, so who appeared today? So I can note down. So, Sydney appeared. Vanilla appeared. Which means that we...
DJ DJ appeared.
Arrow appeared, so he's up to 5.
Wow, DJ appeared.
Chief appeared, he's up to 4.
Yay!
So, Sydney is still trying to catch up to Vanilla, and she still has a heck of a chance, because we found out today there's actually 2 scripts in season 4 that can only be read by 2 people.
They will be mine.
Yeah, right.
Oh, please.
We shall see.
Please, only the hundreds can qualify for this, okay?
Battle!
No.
I can beat you, Vanilla.
Battle.
Ha, you wish.
Battle.
So want this.
Battle.
Not if I get it first.
Me and you and me. Why don't we end the fucking reading? I don't know, because Chief's gonna have to send me a million times. What's so wrong with a little bit of cussing? I can't think of anything that rhymes with cussing.
Fussing!
Right, so, Barry. Must be all your fussing, Barry. All right. Oh, Cindy says she'll be right back.
Oh, I'm right here. That was 5 minutes ago.
That was hella ago, bruh. I don't know what you're up to.
5 minutes. Anyway, so...
Impressions.
I'm actually... I'm actually surprised my burner came out that well. Alright, what was I doing? Oh, yes! Outro! So, if you enjoyed this video, please leave a like. If you thought that was absolutely hilarious, favorite that video, yo. If you want to see more of this stupid stuff, subscribe. Subscribe. And if you'd be so kind, please follow us on Twitter and like us on Facebook. Spread the word, yo. But until the next really horrible thing happens, that's probably my fault. This has been... I'm trying to think of some good thing here. Somebody once told him the world is going to rule him, Chief Skarnek.
Oh, I'm sorry. Did you want to go first?
He's not the sharpest tool in the shed. Aerodynamic, also known as DJ DJ.
Hi.
The ears... Hi. The ears stopped coming, and they won't stop coming for him. Vanilla Beam!
Time to go rest on my giant marshmallow. Hey, Rarity!
Don't you dare go near my Rarity. Yeah, see, she's right here. You're under attack? But, hey now, she's a rock star, she's an all-star, she'll get her game on, and she'll go play Sydney and Selena's Herb Up Their Gothic!
I am not a marshmallow!
It's not a tumor. And me, Lomothai. Thank you for watching, and good night.
Finally! After all is said and done, I get to meet my Prince Joker.
Well, actually, we still haven't left the fucking room yet.
Are you kidding me?
You are! We're doing the best we can! We only get paid 2 cents an hour!
You know knock, what? Knock.
Huh?
Guess who's here?
Oh, no, what's that delivery man?
Could it be?
Guess who's here?
Is it my Joker?
Better. It's Bachelor number one. DJ, DJ.
Sydney, now that Aerodynamic has burst into your house illegally, what are you going to do?
I'm going to go cry in a corner.
You're not going to call the cops?
Stuck on a wall for the rest of eternity.
And Mr. Man on the Wall, in the mirror. Now that you've absolutely ended her hopes and dreams and sent her into depression, what are you going to do now?
I guess go to Five Guys.
We still haven't left the fucking room.
I can do that.
Okay, Rupert.
I am an impressionist after all. I can change my voice.
No, really? Wow, you can change your voice?
No.
Oh my god.
I gotta get out of here. Hey,
Chief. Chief, are you ready? Oh, by the way, Chief, you'll never guess. Vanilla can actually change his voice. It's crazy.
He's an impressionist, you know.
Impossible. It's crazy. Like, we didn't know this whole time.
He hella good.
Oh, boggers, to meet your next bachelors. And here they are.
Oh, the Prince of Darkness, I am.
Wait your turn, bachelor number three.
Until then,
impressions.
The lamest catchphrase in the entire universe.
But it's our catchphrase.
I hope that Burke came in.
No.
Monica, are you cross-dressing?
Maybe. Why does it matter to you, Bacora? You cross-dress all the time, except you just say it's cosplay.
Just because I dress up as Sailor Moon every weekend does not mean that I'm cross-dressing.
Right. And you dress up as Ryoko.
Who?
You know, Ryoko.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Then why do you have that big red and yellow sword?
because you need to choose who I'm doing for Twilight Sparkle.
Alright, alright, I choose. Would some pony help him walk? Akora, get your ass in there and help him walk out.
I'm too busy to do that. Let's see, Ernie,
you're not busy, you're reading Count of Monte Cristo.
So, that counts as busy. Ernie!
What?
Ernie, you go over there and
help
him.
Go help the weird dragon thing.
Don't worry, I got someone on it. This weird puppet thing. Go, Ernie, go help him over.
Sydney, let's have for rarity.
I just realized something.
I sound sexy when I'm slurping?
Not only that.
That's Joey and Tristan.
Joey, look! I have rainbow hair!
That's me, you idiot!
But I have rainbow hair. The fool meant this being that I have super duper strength.
No, it just means that you look ridiculous.
Well, I guess Don looks ridiculous, and he's really strong, right?
Hey, don't you ever, ever make fun of Gaston!
Well, why are you chewing on my arm?
Because I'm a zombie, Peter.
What are you talking about, Metal Man? You lit all those toasters on fire!
Wait, that's it! I've got to rescue Princess Bubble. Oh, wait, wrong universe. God. Why do we have a princess in our universe, Zoidberg? But Zoidberg is a princess. You should rescue me, you should.
Okay, just because it fits so well with Scootaloo, I choose Joe Swanson.
Hey, Peter. I can walk now, but now I can't even fly.
And so the game's Clousdale, as they always do.
So the game's Clousdale, as they always do. Am I the only one who noticed that?
All right. Let me just redo that line.
That's the heck of a blooper.
All right.
Insert the sound of arrows being fired here. Apparently, arrows being fired sound like blowing air.
Pew.
We should take the giant ice thing and push it somewhere else!
What?
Did you actually think that was Chief saying that?
Yes, I did!
Oh, God!
Oh, no.
To be a Chief said, just say,
we should take the giant ice block and push it somewhere else!
I was already thinking of that already.
There's no time, Mother! What are you talking about, Doc? We got all the time in the world! We got a time machine!
Great Scott! If we don't get there in time, or if there's some magical dragon just appear out of nowhere, then all those people are dead by.
That little dragon's looking all pretty brave and strong.
Oh god.
You guess?
It sounded like everyone was saying mucus.
You guess?
Mucus?
You guess? Forgive me for being blood, Spike.
For a second, I thought that said, forgive me for being bullshit.
Forgive me for being bullshit, Spike.
Meh, number 5 don't know. Can you turn back time? Because number 5 would like a do-over on that opening ceremony.
Number 5! You gotta come back with me! Back to the future!
Okay,
all right.
We can turn back time, cause I sure like a do-over and the opening ceremony.
What the?
Oh, fuck
you. Wrong line.
Wrong line!
At least who's not reading
at least now? My point was I can read it, I just read the wrong line sometimes. I don't notice the cadence of the spine.
Sorry.
Shame.
Know your name.
I have a fucking time machine. You guys don't. Show some respect.
How does it feel to have opened the best Equestria Games in Ponyville history, Squirt?
Squirt? Squit?
I said squirt.
No, the lag made it sound like you said squits. Number 5, what do you think you're doing? Please don't use the fire-breathing soda ever again.
You know that it's for testing only.
Hey, number five! What are you doing writing in that dinky little journal?
Yes, what exactly is this?
Number five was having a moment, number one.
Great. Number four speaks up and I take the blame. Perfect.
Who was Bill Cosby?
Oh, boy.
Bill Cosby was
Arrow.
Chief.
That was Chief.
No, it was Chief.
Chief.
Arrow.
Chief. As much as I like taking credit for a job well done.
Yeah, right. Yeah. Job well done. My butt.